Where's the music?
Hey friends. It's D of JD's Organic Productions. Today is day 26 of 100 day vlogging challenge. I have challenged myself to vlog for 100 days consecutive in an attempt to build my brand, JD's Organic Production, and my YouTube channel. I am on day 26 today, and my goal is to be able to, like, you know, edit, upload the same day. But right now, I'm stalled at 6, because, again, my memory was full on my computer, and so I couldn't upload. I had to delete photos. And then yesterday, I got the new photos from Kyle, and I was at the gym. And I have to be really on purpose when I'm home. And so again, sticking to my schedule, doing the reminders. I've even downloaded an app that's called Productive, and it's really great with sending reminders about habitual things that you want to do, so that they get done, because it takes so many times of doing something to make it a habit. And so once you have it as a habit, then it's something that you just get done. And that is the goal, is like to have the really positive things as just a habit. Like this vlogging is just a habit. I want my yoga to be a better habit. Drinking water is on there as a habit. My personal development and my devotional time are under its habits. Those are all things that I consider to be really, really great, and I want them to happen every single day about the same times of the day. And so when they don't, I recognize what I'm doing, you know, but at the same time, I want to get these things done, and I need to stick to them, because the purpose of having them set up at the times that they're set up for and having them in general is because they are part of self-care, healthy management of time, and, you know, all these things. So they're not there as entertainment, you know. And even if they were, then the entertainment would be on there as a form of self-care, because you have to take time to enjoy yourself. So regardless of what is on there, there's a reason and a purpose, and I've planned it out, and I've thought about it, and I've prayed about it, and so I really want to stick to it. And I can see that I'm not, because I get, like, basically a little obsessive over something that I think is great or that I'm doing. And I'm also a little mentally distracted, emotionally distracted. I've, you know, been praying about some stuff and got some words from the Lord about it. And so whenever that happens, I go through this process. And so I recognize that as well. And so I'm learning how to get through the process faster, which is completely relying on the Lord better and more completely, but it's still a process and I'm still going in it. And I thank the Lord that He allows me to see what's happening so that I stay encouraged. And so, and that's an important thing, because a lot of times I would have thought that it was being vain. But what I recognize now is a lot of times it can be deemed vanity if my heart is leaning that way. But if my heart is really leaning towards the Lord, then what I see is as I see certain things as an encouragement. And I need the encouragement. You know, when we are children, we had the encouragement of our parents. As we were growing, we learned to do things. Walk, talk, eat, you know, our you know, academics. We had the encouragement of the people who were with us to do these things and to stay on the path, because sometimes it was hard and challenging. As adults, we, for some reason, seem to think we don't need that encouragement, or that we have to earn it, like, super hard. But you know what? That's not always the case. Sometimes it's just by the simple grace of God that, you know, that we were encouraged. And so I think we need to, you know, accept and acknowledge that too. So it's all good. I'm having a great day. I mean, my gosh, it's 7 o'clock in the morning. How can I not be having a great day? I've only been up since 5. And I've spent, like, the first part of my morning with the Lord. So, like, of course it's a great day. This is how every day should be, and it can be, if I just remember to stay with the Lord all day. So I'm excited, because part of my plan and purpose and schedule is, you know, this time with the Lord and that kind of and that kind of positive activity. And so it is an encouragement, and again, then I get to do all the things that I want to do. I want to do, you know, that's the key thing, is these are things that I want to do. You know, I want to build a YouTube channel. Yes, it's hard. Yes, there's lots of things about it that I'm like struggling with, but I want to do that. I'm doing what I want to do, and I'm trusting that the Lord will meet my needs. And so this is really all about my character. And that is why I enjoy this. It is hard, but I keep pressing in and pressing on, and I want to share it because I pray that I bless people the way that I was blessed by other YouTubers that put themselves out there and keep pressing on and in and sharing. So, I'm just going to say thank you for being with me today. Today's plan. We're going to get off work. We're going to go to the gym. This is about business. So, I'm going to go to the gym, get my workout in, and a little bit more on purpose about logging what I'm eating, and because all of that is data for the other series that I'm hoping to build, which is the I Workout series. And then I'm going to come home and I will be working on editing, God willing, and some writing. So I hope everyone has a wonderful day, and I will see. Does that even make sense? Can you be subconscious and intentional? Yes, right? Because if you read something, they tell you to do positive affirmations, and then it goes in the back of your head, and then like you intentionally are moving towards it, even though you don't realize it, but because you're doing these affirmations constantly, like it just brings you toward what you want. So yes, I believe that you can subconsciously be on purpose.